Leave a like in the next 5 seconds if you guys want to be gifted the Season 2 Battle Pass here in Fortnite.
Before we get started with today's video, I would like to let you guys know I'm gifting subscribers free skins or any cosmetic from the item shop. If you want to receive a gift, follow these steps. Subscribe to the channel, turn all notifications on, drop a like on this video, share the video, and comment down below your Epic Games username letting me know which cosmetic do you want from today's item shop.
If you guys are purchasing any cosmetic from today's item shop, be sure to use supporter creator code BRANNYYT as it does help us support the channel, as I am an Epic partner with Fortnite, and make sure you guys do re-enter every 2 weeks because it does reset as well. And make sure you guys go follow all my socials on Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat as I keep you guys updated with any Fortnite related news. And for the higher chance to be gifted, you must follow my Twitter at BRANNYYT as I am the most active over there. All you guys have to do is just tweet at me, send me a message or a DM, and I'll try to respond to every single one of you guys. But here's a brand new item shop. We got this brand new skin. Obviously, it's the female skin of that one skin. I'm pretty sure it didn't even come out today. I don't know why, but comes with the bag wing. Pretty cool. 1200 V-Bucks. Pretty well worth it. We got the Snow Sniper skin. Basically, the whole permafrost set comes with this chill cons skin, ice intercept, the hailstorm, and then the snow sniper. Pretty cool. And then we got the male versions, the chill out, the arctic intel, ice stalker, and then the snow striker chill out. So we got burnout, pretty cool, with the wheelie bag wing. Got the fortune skin back in return, pretty sick, haven't seen it in a while. The brand new star power emote. And then we got the ground pound emote, and then the wiggle emote, and then the gold digger pickaxe. So if you guys want to be gifted anything from today's item shop, be sure to let me know down in the comments your Epic Games username, spell it out correctly, and let me know your Epic Games username, letting me know which cosmetic you guys want. And make sure you guys let me know if you guys are watching this video in the future. It can be from any future item shops that you guys prefer, so let me know down in the comments what you guys want. Alright guys, welcome to another Fortnite battery up video here in the channel. Today's video, we're gonna show you guys how to get colorful graphics here in Fortnite. I get so many comments on my YouTube videos saying why are your colors so colorful and how are you guys able to do that. So if this video is gonna help you guys out, make sure you guys drop a like on the video as it helps out to get more people to notice this graphic settings. And as well, drop a subscription on the channel as we are so close to 100,000 subscribers. Every single subscription really does help, and I cannot thank you guys so much for the support recently. It really does mean a lot. But let's go ahead and get started. So if you guys see my screen as of right now, you guys can take a look at all of the colorful looks. You guys can see the graphics. Take a look at that Peely, he's looking bright yellowish. We take a look at the battle pass tab. We can hover over all of this. It looks so colorful and vibrant, and basically this is all like from saturation. So if you guys take a look at the battle pass, you can see all of the nice blue colors, every single item that is here in Fortnite. You guys can take a look at this glider, the nice little red. Basically every single color here in Fortnite just stands out, and here in today's video we're going to show you guys how to do that. But let me just go ahead and show you guys just everything, just for you guys can notice all the colorful graphic settings, just in case you guys want to know how to do this. So then there's our tier 100 skin, which looks nice in the black and gold. So let's go ahead and get started. So one more thing, I could show you guys my locker. Basically all these compete tabs look so colorful and bright. My color in the locker just stands out a lot as well. As you guys can see, you guys can take a look at all the favorite skins, just so colorful and vibrant, which makes the game look even better. Which you do not want to have any dry colors, because if you have dry colors, it's basically not gonna like make Fortnite look fun. But take a look at all of my skins, all the like the background cards, the blue rarity, the green, just stands out so much. So the first setting that many people actually try and do is they first go onto the settings. A lot of people think that the brightness has something to do with this, but guys, to be honest, you can have any brightness you guys want. As you guys can see, I can make it so dark, but let's be honest guys, the brightness has nothing to do with these colorful settings. What you guys want to do is, some people turn actual they turn on colorblind on. As you guys can see, you guys can really see the difference a lot. It just looks so weird, but let's be honest guys, this has nothing to do with how to make colorful settings. This is all on your monitor or TV where you guys are on. But for my settings guys, I have this on off, and then my brightness is on 100%. So if you guys want to go ahead and copy it, make sure you guys copy it at 100%. and then have colorblind mode off because basically it has nothing to do with this. And I'm pretty sure these are the only two settings that are here in Fortnite on how you guys are able to make Fortnite look colorful. If you guys can take a look at all these other settings, they're basically all controls and voice chat and music, but basically it has nothing to do with this. So I'ma hover over onto my iPhone and I'ma record from there, showing you guys how I actually have these bright colorful settings, and basically you guys can do it as well. So let me go ahead and switch it out to my iPhone camera and show you guys. Alright guys, so now I am recording through my iPhone. As you guys can see, take a look at the screen. It already looks colorful and vibrant, as you guys can see. I can zoom in on the Peely, it looks so colorful. I could take a look at the battle pass, it already looks colorful as well. Even the item shop icon cards just look so colorful and vibrant. And then my locker as well, with the whole legendary skins and all that. So all of this is gonna stand out once you guys have these colorful settings. So what you guys want to do is, obviously, like I said, every monitor and TV have colorful and like video, picture, image, graphic settings. If you guys take a look at over here, I am on a BenQ monitor. I'm pretty sure you guys know that as of right now, as I made a stretch resolution video. So this BenQ monitor is kind of mostly known for gaming, so that's one of the reasons why I got it. The last time I made a video about the graphic settings, I did have an HP monitor, so I decided to upgrade just because this BenQ monitor does have so many colorful graphic settings, and I obviously wanted to try out. So what you guys want to do is go over right here. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys know what this is. This has all of the picture image settings, which makes it look stand out. So as you guys can see, I just turned it off by accident. But as you guys can see, some of these settings have something to do with the image. So what you guys want to do is click on the one that you guys are obviously on. So if you're on a TV or a monitor, click on picture mode. And as you guys can see, here are a lot of different settings. So we got standard, movie, photo, sRGB, echo, RTS1, RTS2. We have gamer one, and then we just have so many options. And then look, you guys can see the difference. I don't know if you guys see it. It changes the color and all. Some may turn black, turn off your screen. And I don't know if you guys can see it, but basically all of these are all settings that you guys have to mess around with. And if you guys are on a BenQ monitor, the same one as I am, I don't know what this monitor is called, but it is a 24-inch. If you guys see a photo setting, which that is the one I am on, that is the most saturated one. And that's basically how you guys are able to get these colorful settings. And I'm pretty sure there is separate settings that are not by default. I'm pretty sure some of these settings have like sharpness. You guys can mess around with the saturation. So as you guys can see right here, we got brightness, contrast. Contrast, I'm pretty sure, does mess around with it as well. But other than that, the color temperature is basically gonna make everything turn blue. My brightness for the monitor, I am on 100%. My actual contrast is on 50%. But like I said, I feel like contrast has nothing to do with it. Just make sure you guys have a picture mode setting, and then you guys can go ahead and mess with the default settings and just try to increase the saturation, because the saturation is the one that brings up the colors here in Fortnite. And then over here, I am on my monitor as well. This is a Dell monitor. This may be different. This is what I work on for my thumbnails. And by the way, guys, hit that subscribe button as we're trying to hit 100,000. But you guys can see this is for my thumbnails. I have Photoshop open. I know there's been a lot of people saying, how do I do my thumbnails? This is all Photoshop. A lot of people been stealing my thumbnails on YouTube. As you can see, this is all from Photoshop, guys. So I make all my thumbnails here on the channel. But as you guys see over here, I don't know if you guys can see the buttons. We have separate settings as well. We could go ahead and click on it. Some of these may be different. As you guys can see, we have a different preset mode. As you guys can see the difference. I don't know if you guys notice it. It turns like a yellow color. We got the warm, cool. And then there is a custom color right there. Make it focus. There is a custom color that you guys can go ahead and change. So all of this just has to do with the actual monitor picture image settings. As you guys can see, we have a brightness setting and then a contrast setting as well. So if you guys just want to have your own custom settings, all you really have to do is just mess around with the saturation or even the contrast. If you guys do not have a saturation like setting, just mess around with the contrast and then try to mess around with the brightness just for it won't look too bright or too dark. And by the way, guys, I just want to quickly say, a lot of people been asking, what does my setup look like? So here it is, guys. Basic monitor setup. We got two monitors. I know I never make videos like these setup videos, but let me go ahead and show you guys. I'm on a PS4. Got the BenQ monitor. Got my Corsair headset. PS4 controller, as you guys know, I'm PS4. And then here's all my cables, which kind of is messy, but, you know, gets the job done, I guess. Razer keyboard, nothing really big, guys, but, you know, a lot of people have just been asking. So that's all you have to do, guys. Let me go ahead and transition over to my actual PS4 and show you guys some actual gameplay of how these like graphic settings look.
But yeah, pretty awesome, guys. Like I said, it just has to do with the actual saturation settings, the contrast and brightness. Other than those settings, all other whole colorblind just makes the colors look different. Like I said, this has nothing to do with anything of what I said, so make sure you guys are just messing around with your TV and monitor settings. But now I want to go ahead and go into an actual game of the actual brand new map of season 2, just because I want to show you guys what the brand new like map locations actually look like. So let me go ahead and launch over into a game just for you guys can see the difference. As you guys can see, you can start noticing all of the nice green grass. It's like so colorful and vibrant. You guys know this is the season 2 map. There is like a lot of colorful like locations that did change, like the middle island. We have a yacht over there, and then obviously the most one that's gonna stand out is Steamy Stacks with the whole purple color. So if I go over here to Steamy Stacks and fly around the yacht, you guys can start noticing the bright vibrant colors. So let me go ahead and go on top of here just so you guys can see. So if you guys go inside, it is day as well, which makes the colors look way better. But here is a Steamy Stacks. You guys can take a look at the purple stuff. It looks so nice and vibrant. As you guys can see, you guys can go ahead and go under. It's obviously gonna look nice as this has been here since season 1, since chapter 2 did launch. So if you guys can take a look at the umbrella, the gold on black is colorful as well. But take a look at this, guys. So everything right here is just so colorful and just makes Fortnite look way better. So I really hope you guys try out this method, just because it is so easy, guys. You're just messing around with your colorful settings on your monitor and TV, and it just makes your colors look way better. And I feel like these colors are gonna make you wanna play Fortnite more. So if you guys can take a look at the water, it's so vibrant as well. It just looks so nice. It gives out a nice look. If we go inside the yacht, you guys can take a look, which I can't even go in. And I can't even go in. All right, but let me go ahead and destroy this real quick, just for you guys can go ahead and notice it. All right. So we go in. If I can jump, bro, I can't even jump. What the, bro? Oh no, guys, what is this? Get me out of here, bro. All right, so if you guys can take a look at all this, it's just so colorful, man. All right, we are in here now. Take a look at all this gold, man. I don't know if you guys can see this, this purple, everything just stands out so much. You guys can take a look at all of that. All of the gold that is inside here is just so nice. And like I said, it's gonna make you wanna play Fortnite more. Probably we go up here, there could be more other stuff that obviously looks vibrant as well. I don't know, but other than that, guys, this is all you guys have to do. Mess around with your monitor settings. Here it is, this gold and red stuff going on. We have this little outside thing. The plants look so nice and colorful as well. So hopefully you guys try out this method, man. Let me know down in the comments if you guys have any questions or problems, if I could be able to hook you guys up, because this method is just simple and easy to do. You guys can take a look at the chest. It looks vibrant and colorful. But other than that, guys, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to drop a like. If you guys found it helpful, make sure to share it out, for it can help a lot of people, as a lot of people want to try out this method. But other than that, guys, thank you guys for watching, and I'm gonna catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.